I don't think of Lightshed as something for a guided tour, as an item on a guided tour about the history of Vancouver. It's more that I used the material history of Vancouver, the industrial history of Vancouver, to suggest to me some forms and some conditions.
It's called a city work shed or a municipal shed. It's the kind of thing that sat on the government wharf, which had red railings, where people would store freight or where their fishermen would store nets or any number of things. Typically where cities or businesses in cities would store materials. In her case, she's gone beyond, I think, a narrow nostalgia or historicism by adding other elements and components that are consistent with her art practice. It just has many, many beautiful elements, and I think it has come really to define that corner of the seawall. Very, very specific to Cole Harbour, but also a lot of reference up and down the coast of British Columbia.
One of the conditions that I used was the fact that almost everything that is built in a city has a lifespan of greater or less years according to the material. And Vancouver's history is a hasty place, and things were put together very quickly. The materials we used don't last hundreds of years, especially under rigorous conditions as you find at the waterfront. So a city like Vancouver, which isn't very old in the first place, its material history deteriorates really quickly, and we lose it. It just disappears. And that's not exactly lamentable, because that is the way we do it. You know, that's our culture, basically. So it's not as though we're contradicting our plan. We didn't have a plan to have permanence. So we're being consistent. We build hasty places and we let them go quickly.
Some of the local folks thought, you know, this is going to be an eyesore. It's going to look like an old shed. It's going to block our views. And a few months later, after it opened, I went by for the opening ceremonies, and I saw one of the neighbors who'd been so vociferously opposed to it. And she came up to me and she said, "I love this. It's my favorite thing." And she just had to see it in person. And I'll bet that some of those same people will defend that piece of art till the cows come home. It's on every postcard now. It's a great piece.
I couldn't really scale barnacles down, so because they're cast from real barnacles. So there's a bit of a glitch in the scale part of it, because I also couldn't figure out how to scale down wood. What is a scaled down board? Is the grain tighter? You know, I went through the thoughts of what that implication is. So in fact, the scaling down is of the man-made things. So the building size, all the door is kind of short. Because it was a big freight shed, the door was enormous. The present door at Lightshed is about 4 feet high. The original freight shed, it was a big man door. It was a tall man door. And then there's a freight door. And so I did scale down all the hardware. So what happens when it's scaled down is it becomes a kind of acuter size. It becomes more like a fisherman's shack or something more domestic. And so it has that, as a sculpture, it has that appeal.